There you go. Hi guys. Hi everyone. Hi. Hi Carly. Hi boss lady. Hi dragon. Hey gorgeous. Good afternoon. Good afternoon Violet. Hey mom. Don't you dare call me mom G.S. Buckley after you had me look at that huge, huge, huge thing. That thing that was bigger than a cucumber. Today I'm mom. Yesterday I was like, girl, check it out. Hi, Damien, thanks. Hi, MD and AF joined. Hi, Gross. Oh, did you see it, Violet? No, I actually woke up thinking about it. And I was like, yeah, he has to be a porn star. Sorry, nobody wants to do that. It's too much. Pretty in blue. This is, how's it coming across? This is green. Yeah, it's no effect. I feel sorry for the women that have to work with him. It is not cool. How are you guys today? So there's a couple of things. I you know what? I like to use my space machine to laugh out loud. It's gross. I was thinking of using my time with you guys more effectively, Anaconda. I'm telling you, so gross. I can't even like, I would be good for a year. Oh, that's what I was looking for. I was looking for Twitter. I volunteered today. Oh my God, Intuitive Waters. That is an amazing thing. I have to tell everyone, let's take a page from Intuitive Waters because you know what I want to do? Okay. Oh my God, I'm so glad you said that Intuitive. You know what I want to do? I want to, but I can't find, I guess when drugs and alcohol was a bigger issue, there used to be women that used to go to the NICU and hold the babies while their moms may not have had recovery from some drug issues. I wish I could just hold the poor NICU babies that maybe have been abandoned by their mommies. Hi, Night of Champagne. One of my favorite names. But in any case, so I've been looking how to get involved. Because I'm good for that. Plus, I have healing qualities. And so, I just want to hold the babies. That's what I'm good at. I can't build homes, but I can hold something to my heart and heal them. Really? Yeah, it's really sad, but what if like I could prevent that sadness? What if I could, you know, give that baby something, you know, before it, I don't know. That's what I want to do. So if you guys find any information in Los Angeles where I could do that. I would like that. That's what I think I could spend the rest of my life doing that, seriously. Hi, Catco 18, how are you? The cards say do it. Oh my God, okay, I'll do it. I know, we're like the sun. We want to give, we want to provide. We are the sun. We want to make everybody all warm and fuzzy. Whatever. Okay, so I was wondering if I should do a psychic review. Still give away free reading, don't get me wrong, but also do a psychic review in this hour that I talk with you guys. That's what I mean, Machina. The newborns that may have come addicted and the mothers aren't available, or sometimes they just got to go on their way and the baby's left in the hospital. You know, maybe I just would think that if there's any mom out there that has some drug issues, and it means she has boyfriend issues, and it means the baby might have been NICU, means they're born early. You know, you love my hair. Oh, thank you, Damien. thank you. I'm going so Afrocentric, going home to the motherland. And Colleen, we are gonna find out what part of blackness Africa I'm from. We're gonna find out. Hi, Hakan Bey. Hi, honey. People are actually hired to do that. I would do it as a job. I could care less. I would do that all day as a job. Queen of Egypt. I know, right? stop complimenting me. I can't think. So tomorrow, because I'm already prepared to do it tomorrow, I'm going to do Black China and this whole Kardashian name thing. But psychic. But hold on, guys. Psychic review. W. Let's see. Sometimes, oh no, psychic. Sometimes I put what my future readings are going to be like. Kanye, why did he go crazy? Ray J got married. Oh, see, I haven't updated it lately. Anthony Weiner, jail time. Who cares about him? Okay, so I haven't been updating my psychic reviews, because what I do is I post psychic reviews on Twitter and then I go back to see what I haven't done. At the very least, do you guys, hi Kelsey, do you guys kind of see the atmosphere changing with Russia finagling the election? Can you guys see that maybe December 19th could get more real? That maybe that the momentum, I was watching the news last night at 11 and it came on as breaking news. Can you guys see that something could change if possible? I mean, I'm hoping. Yes, I sort of seen it. See, the momentum is there. So now people are, America's scared. America's scared that Russia really did play into our election, really did help Trump to succeed numerically, And it's kind of like cheating. If that's, don't believe the hype. I don't know if it's hype, guys. I think that something is definitely wrong. I think every day it's going to build and build and build until they're going to be forced to I think it's going to build right up until December 19th. I think those electors are really going to have to consider what they're doing when they re-vote. And I think that's what it's building up to. So guys, come on. Prayer works. Prayer works. We really have to not have Trump in the White House. We can't have Ivanka pretending to be the first lady, you know. We can't have his daughter, you know, calming the savage beast inside of, you know, Trump. And we can't have Trump using his Twitter account like he's having a conversation with someone. Like, we need a responsible person in the White House. So, please, let's all pray. Come on, guys. Prayer works. We can't give up. Colleen just sent me something. Let me just see what you sent me. Where'd you send it? Facebook, Colleen? This is discussion hour. Did you see the two Joshua prediction? Is an African heel or something? Wait, what happened? Yeah, that's interesting. The White House is a part-time job for him. I love that. Yeah, I heard something about The Apprentice. NBC, really? Really, NBC? Really, Mark Burnett? You guys are disgusting. Everybody's disgusting. You all are disgusting. Not Periscope. NBC, Mark Burnett, The Apprentice. Who's going to watch The Apprentice anyway? With that dude. I don't like him either. He's disgusting. He slept with that nanny. Ugh. Colleen. Oh my God, I love you. Thank you. Colleen just sent me something. Spence Chapman Services to Family and Children. Oh my God. I will read this article when I get off the phone. This is, you know, a man holding and nurturing a newborn or a NICU. Oh my God, I would do that all day, every day. Is this for California though, Spence Chapman? I'll check it out. Don't worry, honey. I'll check it out. Relaxing with me. Oh, my God. I could do that all day, every day. I do it with my grandson. I don't even let him breathe. I'm like, come to me. I would breastfeed my grandson again. All right, do you guys want a free reading? Yes? No? Or do you want me to do a psychic review on something? Hi, wife. 2SG. Hi, honey. Do you guys want a free reading? Yes, I agree. I do rather the moms leave the baby at the hospital than for the moms to go home with these babies and not be prepared. I agree with you. Sometimes time is the best thing. Like, sometimes just leave the baby. There may not be any laws, but there are some bylaws. There are some conditions in being president that's been in place, and every president has abided by not having any outside business while they're being, you know, running the country. And Trump, who can, you know, he's the same guy that gets around bankruptcy, so he knows how to get around, you know, any law that's not written. That's the one thing he's good at. If it's not written, he can get away with it. Thank you. Thank you. No, G.S. Buckley, no. You can tell. The one thing you can tell is that that's not happening. Mm-mm. Yeah, well. Okay. Who wants a reading? But I don't have a paper on me. I don't have a paper on me, and it has to be done fair. So, reading. Me, okay. Okay, you guys do want a reading. Hold on. And is there a psychic review anybody wants me to do as well? Yes, read Ivanka. No, I'm not going to read Ivanka. Because I don't like her daddy. And I already read her. She's going to be the first lady. I already said that. Really? Ivanka? Really? And I'm hungry. But I also stay hungry. She got a bad daddy. You know who I want to read? Actually, I want to read Ivanka's husband. That's who I want to read. Who the hell is he? Where did he come from? Okay. No, this is a free reading, but Boss Lady, the way I do it on Saturdays is it's a free reading on Saturdays. But if you want to pay for a reading, it's 818-985-2010, 818-985-2010. So, it does not have to be anybody famous. I only do the famous people because they're so easy and they're so open. And they don't know I'm doing a reading on them, so they can't trick the energy that's coming from me. Which is why it's so accurate, guys. Sometimes when you guys call, you guys want to trick me. And it makes it that much more difficult. So lately I've been telling everyone, look at a brick wall. Show me a brick wall in your mind's eye. Breathe through your nose and out through your mouth, because I've got to get all the impressions that you're trying to give me away from me, because I need to do an accurate reading. And if you guys trick me, then it takes me that much longer to get around the bend. I always get there, because when I'm adamant about something, then everyone's like, well, actually, and I'm like, no, not actually. Oh, I just wasted 10 minutes. Yeah, some people don't believe. That's true, but they're still calling. So a part of them believes, you know. I'm the bomb. Thank you. But the reason why I do celebrity readings, the reason why I do celebrity readings is to prove to you all that I'm accurate. And just getting back to the presidency, I think one of the most disappointing responses I've ever gotten from anybody. Like, I get people that, like, you need to believe in Jesus. Gotcha. Gotcha. You know, I get comments like that. I usually don't get comments of, like, hatred because I didn't pick, you know, because Hillary didn't become president. And it was kind of disappointing because I'm sitting there by myself. I have no support. Trump wins, and I'm sitting there looking like a buffoon to myself. And I'm getting all these comments on Instagram. And God never fails me, you know. Before I put my feet on the ground, I pray to Jesus. I'm like, Jesus, people need me. So can you be inside of me? Can you be my mouth? Can you be my tool? And I ask God, if I did this, I don't want my ego in this. So can I call out your name, God? And if I call out your name, will you let me do this for a living? And so when Hillary didn't win, I had people that lost faith in me. I lost my numbers on Instagram. And I was disappointed maybe for about a week. But then I decided I'm not going to care. Like, I am what I am. And then now we see weeks going in, we see Hillary did win the popular vote. So if she won a popular vote, how in the hell did she not become president? And now we're hearing that there's been some manipulation. And it's like, see, people, have a little faith. Have a little faith. Just because something doesn't come out the way you vision it to come out doesn't mean it's not going to come out. It always comes out. And sometimes I tell people what to do with their relationships. They don't believe me. And that's okay, because you have your free will and you go about doing, and then it just takes longer. But what I say comes out just takes longer because it's hard for you to believe that what you want and what's actually happening is two different things. But have a little faith, you know, have a little faith that God has got you. Write letters to God. Tell God what you want from now on. You know, if you want a job, write that letter to God. If you want a good man, write that letter to God. But when you write that letter to God, you got to be able to tell God, I'm willing to change. This is what I want. I don't just want a job. I want to tell you, God, I'm going to go to work on time. I'm going to do my job every day. I'm not going to be absent. There's things you have to do. You want a good man? You want a good woman? Do the work to keep that person. Figure it out. Tell God what you want. Bring him in. And by the way, don't be so specific. Tell God about the characteristic of the person that you want. And then be the characteristic of the person that you're asking God to bring to you. Be better. Everybody be better. Because if you're better, if I'm better, I will make everything better. I know God's going to bring what you want if you're better. Start with you, everyone. Okay, did I just lecture? I haven't lectured in a while. Queen. I haven't lectured in a while. Hold on. Okay, so with all that being said, Lamb of the Lord. Oh, I am. Church on Saturday. Tracy, I'm still... okay, wait. No. I got some names. T-Squad was one. Shoot. T-Squad, and then Tracy T Finders, that's what it was. That's what it was. Tracy's T Finders, no brownie, and T Squad. Tracy's T Finders. You know why I like Tracy T Finders? Because you all will send me DMs to let me know what is going out there, because I never check the blog. So when you all send it to me, I'm like, oh, well, look at that. I'm pretty right about that. But I don't investigate the blogs, but you all send it to me, and then I look at the blogs. Tracy T Finders, I love that. The T's, TTT, the T's. The T's. Do you like that? Because that's T, my name. And then T, sip it. And then T's. Oh, let me see if I can get a call in real quick before I do you guys. Hi, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hello? Now, why isn't this working today? Let me see. Let's see if I can get this call in real quick. I almost forgot. Are you there?
Hello?
Hi.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes. I was trying to get you on. I'm here. Can you hear me? Who's this?
Alyssa's mom, remember I sent you the heart?
Alyssa! How are you, honey?
How are you?
Well, I'm actually trying to get you on your the piece that you gave me. Oh, that's because, okay, let me turn it on. Hold on.
AUX mode. FM mode.
Don't say anything just yet. Can you hear
Bluetooth
me?
Mode.
Can you hear me? Alyssa?
AUX mode.
Alyssa?
Can you hear me?
Yes! Hi,
yes, honey. Can you hear me? Hi, I'm supposed to call you. Me and Isaac
were
listening to you yesterday on Periscope.
Oh, is he listening to me too now? That's hilarious.
You know what? And I was in his office, and I was just like, we was watching a live talk, and I said, do you see what she has in her hand? And he was like, what?
Wait a second, but I was talking about him. I was like, he's a great guy, and you're so lucky to find him, and I'm so embarrassed now. He was listening.
Well, only a little bit, but not too much, but he was just so excited that you showed digital speaker.
He said,
was like, oh, that's so awesome.
Wait.
He was excited.
Oh.
Yeah, when you showed him his digital speaker, he was like, wow. He said, Periscope is awesome.
Yeah, Periscope is awesome. So, guys, this is Alyssa. I was talking about Alyssa yesterday, Tracy's TIs. Y'all just creating things. This is the speaker that Alyssa sent me, and this is Alyssa on the phone. Yeah. Well, listen, get a free reading. What do you want to know?
Melissa.
Oh, Alyssa. Melissa. You're Melissa. And, okay, so let me tell everyone the story. Oh, my God, she's talking so much. Let me tell everybody the story. I met Alyssa because I think... You used to call into the radio show, right? But Alyssa was Alyssa alive at the time?
Yeah, I called you one time when Alyssa was alive.
Yes.
And then I called you afterwards when Alyssa had passed away.
So she had a little baby that was born with a heart condition. And I used to do the Blog Talk Radio, which is no visual. And she called and she was talking about her baby and a heart condition. And it must have been like, it was like 8 months or a year when she called back to say the baby, her name's Alyssa, Alyssa had died.
Yeah.
And so, you and I have been, you know, online friends ever since. You know, I still have a plant, that plant that you showed me, I brought a plant just like that, and I named the plant Alyssa.
Oh,
I'll send you a picture. It's growing awkward, though. It's like growing really skinny and up. It's like really awkward. I don't know what to do with it. I don't know if I should plant it into a big... I don't know what to do with it. So, but it's growing. It's a money plant. The money plant. Do you guys know the money plant? So I was on a bus one day and this guy gave me this little tiny money plant and you had showed the money plant to me and then the guy gave it to me and I was like, oh, this is my Alyssa plant. I'll send you a picture.
Oh, definitely. And my daughter just birthday is going to be next month.
Yeah.
And then her 53 and then her pass is going to be in February.
Her what?
Her passing is her, the year that she passed.
Is she's 2 years past now?
It's gonna be.
Gonna be 2 years in February.
Yeah,
because
she died in February
2015. Yeah. Well, yeah. With all that being said, of course, when a woman has a baby that passes on, it's like, what do you do with your life? What do you do with that? You know, what do you do? And so me and Melissa just stay close, you know, Facebook friends. And lo and behold, you know, somehow, some way, online, you met this guy online, right?
Yes, and I remember I had a personal meeting with you, and you said to me, you know, you're going to meet someone that's close by you, and I was like, I was like, that's not
going to
happen.
I don't know if you guys are hearing it, but she's saying that I said that she was going to meet someone close by her because she lives in upstate New York, so there's not that much dating going on up there.
Yeah, I live in Mount Vernon. We're
Dental,
Washington.
Oh, you live in Mount Vernon. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It's a four-star mouth, so mm-hmm. You're not
going
to really get a good guy.
Yeah, I know Mount Vernon. Yeah. But where is he from? He's from Mount Vernon?
Okay. No, he's actually from the Bronx.
Oh, what part of the Bronx? I know the Bronx very well.
I have no idea.
Oh, I know the Bronx so well.
Yeah, and his mom is... Her sixth mom is Cuban and black. His mother's black and his grandma's black and his grandpa's Cuban.
Wow.
And I was like, wow.
Yeah. Well, just let me tell everyone, and to you too, Melissa, I am so proud of your recovery. I can't imagine what you went through, but you have been so strong and so steady and so emotionally supportive of yourself. All right? You did not lose control. You just, you know, you're spiritually strong, and that's really hard under the circumstances. So you really, really need to congratulate yourself for allowing yourself to move forward, enjoy life, not making everybody else affected, you know, from your loss. You took it like a woman, and you're like, spiritually, I'd like to be like you under the circumstances. So
well, I thank you for like being in my life, and you know, I feel like my daughter made sure that she had everything aligned for me to have certain people around me. You know, and
I also think your daughter didn't want you to miss the love, if that makes any sense. So I feel like she may have come along. I mean, I feel like her passing was so you can get redirected so that you can find really good love in your life. Give me a question. Let me do a reading on you. Give me a question.
Oh my goodness. You know, what I was about to say, I think when, you know, he doesn't have no children. And mm-hmm. He never has to go to a funeral. He never been through death before.
Okay.
So that is so different for me. Mm. You know?
Yeah.
That is different. I don't know what to ask because, No, I feel like I'm
going to
let you and Spirit just do your thing.
Okay, I'll take it. Me and Spirit work very well together. I'll take it.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm finding, especially since all my Instagram people have come along, because a lot of what I do is new for them. And so I'm finding a general reading works so much more better. Especially for my newer people. Once you get readings, please, God, just ask a question. I know. Melissa, they can barely hear you, and I don't know how to turn this up.
Really?
Hold on.
Oh, my goodness.
See? Melissa?
Yeah, you can hear me?
Hold on.
Can you hear me?
A little bit. It's not that good.
Okay.
We'll figure it out.
Good.
This is usually booming. I think it's your phone. Because it's usually very loud. Okay, hold on.
It's my phone because I got my AirPods.
Oh, you have your earpiece in?
Yeah, so maybe I might take my earpiece out. Hold on.
Take your earpiece out and put it on speakerphone. Please, God, tell me what's around Melissa.
Okay, great. What was I about to say?
Better. What's around, God, what's around Melissa?
You know, my daughter has her Facebook page they made for her when she was in the hospital.
Yeah.
And it's called A Heart for Alyssa.
Tell me what it's called again, the Facebook page? A Heart for Alyssa.
Yes.
Yeah, they were looking for a heart for her.
My family was trying to, have everybody pray and stuff so the deceased baby can get a heart. And, And, yeah, it's called A Heart for Alyssa. And all I ask is, for her birthday or for, you know, her passing, if anybody wants to, they can just write happy birthday or something, you know.
Okay.
Just good prayers, but what?
Okay. So it's her Facebook page is called A Heart for Alyssa. And the only request that she has, you know what, I have to tell you, this kid is, I don't know, maybe I shouldn't say this, but this kid is a little magical. All Melissa wants, if you want, everyone, hold on, all Melissa wants is that if you can go to her page and wish her happy birthday, but I know magical kids. And ever since I got my Alyssa plant, I don't think I've suffered, seriously. So I would say God works in mysterious ways. If you guys want to wish Melissa, Alyssa, a happy birthday and then put in a prayer request, she's close to God now. She'll be able to whisper in God's ear very easily. All right.
Definitely.
All right. I'm going to start talking.
Okay.
Okay. I feel like you're in love, or he's in love, or you guys need to grab the love. Grab it. Grab the love. You're secure. He's secure. Grab it. There's fulfillment and harmony and protection coming from this man. But you're also very, very protective. I feel
That's
like for the
true.
Thank you. I feel like for the first time you are at peace. That your turmoil and your happiness are now blending a lot easily, fluidly. All right? So the dark side of your pain is becoming less and less. Doesn't mean that you forget Alyssa. Remember that. It's not about forgetting Alyssa. It is about releasing the pain that came from her passing. And the pain is, you know, it's emotional, but it's in your head. And so just when you think that maybe Alyssa thinks I've forgotten about her, then you bring the pain back because you're trying to prove to her you will never be forgotten, ever.
Absolutely.
But you may not be letting Alyssa grow in heaven.
Wow. That's something probably I need to hear, because every day I feel like, and you know, like I've been having such an emotional week that it's becoming to a point that I'm like, oh my gosh, I miss my child. I want my child. And then, you know, sometimes because my child wasn't a child that cried when she was in pain. Mm-hmm. And she never was a child that cried, got shot, like a little shot from the doctor.
Mm-hmm.
And she never, if you cry, she will go and actually pat you on your back to make you relax.
Oh, she would have been so loving. But, your destiny is being inhibited.
Mm-hmm.
So it's important, Melissa, to Like, I have to say, if you really, really love your daughter, it's time to let her grow in heaven. Mm-hmm. It's time to let her grow in heaven.
Yeah. That's big. But I, you know, because I know that everybody does like a little emotional pull for her, you know? Yeah. You know, she feels it a lot, like everybody relax, you know?
Yeah.
It's like giving God back his child.
Yeah, Melissa. Yeah, that's God's child. He called her home.
Yeah.
It's just time.
Thank you for using Blog Talk Radio. Goodbye.
Melissa? Oh my God. I didn't think to tell her. Let me see if I can get her on the phone. Oh, that's too funny. You're on the radio. I forgot.
No, that's okay.
I totally forgot you were on the radio.
Oh, no, that's okay. You know, I just want to thank you so much for being there, you know. I feel like this is something like later on I can like express to my mom, because it seems like it's the hardest for her to like, you know, the little miracles my daughter show her, like she'll show her the pennies, the feathers, or like we get children, they'll talk to us and say hi or do stuff that she likes to do.
Mm-hmm.
So we get that a lot.
I think some of the signs that you're going to get if you allow her to go, some of the signs mm-hmm. that you're going to get is light, something about light, 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 coming light. I don't know if it's flickering lights or... You'll tell me later. The signs are going to begin to change. Especially if you release her. The signs will change. She's going to take on this, you know, the atmosphere. Lights. Stars.
Wow.
Stars. Lights.
Because she loves Christmas. Even though she didn't get to experience it too much, she loved it.
Yeah, but she's there with
and
Christ. She's with the guy that we're celebrating. She got better. She got better than what we're doing. We're putting up Christmas trees. She got Jesus.
You know what? You know the money candle that you came up with that you have put on YouTube?
Yeah, that's the money candle. That's the one I call Alyssa.
You call Alyssa the money candle?
No, my money candle. I call Alyssa.
No way, because, you know, I didn't call Alyssa, but every day I do, like, I'll say her name, I'll say, you know, spirit guides and stuff, and I do, like, a little prayer every, you know, set my attention every morning before I leave the house.
Right.
And I light the money candle that I made from watching YouTube on YouTube.
Huh. Listen, I got something to say about your boyfriend.
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, you're definitely going to marry this guy, okay? So I want you to begin to settle in. I really have a fear that you're afraid to be happy. You're afraid to go to the next step and get married and, you know, create another baby, which means you would forget Alyssa. So that's why this reading is important, all right? Because Alyssa does want you to go on with your life, right?
Yeah.
Marriage is here. Marriage is here and it's in two different cards. But I do get this woman that's on the fence. Because marriage means happiness. Marriage means you get allowed to be happy. You get to go on with your life, and you don't want to do that. So I'm asking you to work on releasing Alyssa for a reason, because you deserve to be happy, and Alyssa deserves to do bigger work up there on your behalf. Like, that's what she wants to do. She came down with a pure heart that wasn't ticking. But she still wants to use her heart. And some of the people are saying, please look at Persico, because they're like, let go and let God. Everything happens for a reason. Thank you, guys.
It does. It really does. And I was about to tell you, I'll say something really quick.
Well, wait. Before you tell me, I'm concerned for your guy's health.
Isaac?
Yep.
Oh, because his,
You don't have to say it. Don't say it out loud.
Okay.
Yeah.
But you already know what it is. Yeah, I already told you what it is.
Yeah. Yeah. It's still being compromised. He's not doing the right thing. Something's not right. He needs to be better at it. It's being compromised.
Because I was thinking, like, I wanted to start, making his meals for him.
Here's what I want you to do more than anything. I want him to, it's a numbers game. Diabetes is a numbers game. He needs to check his numbers every day.
I don't think he does that.
Right. Exactly. But somebody else is telling me vegan diets is a lifesaver for diabetes. I didn't know that.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Geez, Buckley. Good.
You know, it works in his father's family.
Well,
him and his sister have it.
His age bracket.
His father has it too.
His age bracket tells me it's like diabetes 1, so that usually is hereditary. But everybody's telling me vegan diet. That's what everybody's saying here. Mm-hmm. But he needs to check his numbers. His numbers are high, and he's borderline. He's potentially going to collapse.
Wow.
Vegan or... They're saying vegan or pescatarian. Hi, Grandma. I have no idea. Look at it on a Periscope, and then look it up on Google. Pescatarian. Fish... They're saying fish diet works wonders, too. Fish diet. They're saying fish diet. Really? Huh. Fish foods, I believe. Oh, my God. I love fish. Oh, that's pescatarian. Pescatarian is fish diet. Fish diet is pescatarian. I didn't know that. Thank you, guys.
Oh, wow. Okay, so that's different, too. Because, you know, I want to make sure that he is.
Thank you, D.S. Buckley.
Wow.
So.
I'll definitely make sure that I research and, like, you know, I'll just sit down with him and just make sure he checks those things, because he never talks about checking any numbers.
They're saying salmon, cod, scallop, limit the shrimp, they're saying. Limit your shrimp. Diabetes can cause kidney failure, and it's very, very serious. It also... What is it when you black out from, sometimes you can just black out from too much sugar, too. And it's not good. So, please, if you're going to help him, there's two ways you can help him. He needs to check his numbers. He needs to own his numbers. He needs to look at how high his sugar is. And he needs to change his diet. And if you could make his lunch for him, you know, do it.
Wow, because I will, you know.
But you know what, Melissa? Everything he drinks also, like, he's got to look at the carbohydrates, and he has to look at the sugar. So it's my understanding you can drink anything that has less than 5 grams of sugar. But for the most part, he should only be drinking water.
Wow, just water.
Oh, G.S. Buckley is saying coconut water. I love coconut water because I'm Caribbean. Coconut water. More water. No more carbs. Less carbs. They don't break down the sugar. No soda. Something about alkaline diets are good, too. I'm trying to buy an alkaline water filter right now. Huh. No acid. No acid at all. Oh, this is very important. No drinking. That every drink is loaded with sugar. Read all your labels. Get a low carb. I'm like reading verbatim. Thank you, everyone. Get a low carb cookbook.
I know you were telling me about cookbook earlier. You were saying for me to try to get something that can help.
Lemon. Put lemon in the water. Tell her to. There, G.S. Buckley. How, G.S. Buckley? Because Periscope doesn't have a message thing. G.S. Buckley is saying to message her. G.S. Buckley, are you on Instagram? Do I know you on Instagram? Or
no,
Facebook? Not you, Melissa. G.S. Buckley, do I have you on Facebook or Instagram? Because then I can hook you guys up through Facebook. Gabby? That's Gabby! I'll hook you guys up. Gabby! You and that porn star, I had no idea it was you! Oh my God. Gabby! No wonder you call me mom. Okay, I'm gonna hook you guys up. I'm gonna hook you up with this girl named Gabby, Melissa, and you all can have some conversations about her, about how she can assist you to assist him.
Yeah, because all the time, it's like all the time I just be thinking like, you know, he always says that he's fine, or he'll just, you know, shove it off.
Don't believe a diabetic. The one thing I can tell you about diabetics, they lie.
Really?
Yes, they don't want to own it. They don't want to participate in, you know, quality of life. Like, it's really hard for diabetics. They lie all the time. You're like, are you taking your pills? Yes. They wind up in a hospital. You can't wind up in a hospital if you're taking your pills. What are you doing? All right, honey. Melissa, I'm going to get up out of here. It's very important to understand, more than anything, this reading is about your growth here on Earth. You are allowed to get married. You are allowed to make more children. And if you must release Alyssa, because I have a funny feeling Alyssa wants to come back in. You will have another baby. You will have another girl. And, but there's a process. So if you don't let her go, she can't find her way back in.
Oh, wow. Because I remember you said to me, Melissa, how you know that God won't let you have Alyssa back?
Mm.
And you told me that months ago.
Wow. Well, I'm looking at the cards and I see a little girl that wants to come back in, but she's falling in my hopes and fears. And the two reasons why she's falling in my hopes and fears is because you're not letting the original Alyssa go, and your guy got some health problems that's going to compromise the ability for her to come back in.
Wow. This is big. You know I'm going to listen back to this.
Huh?
You know I'm definitely going to be listening back to this, and you do know on the record that you're going to be the one to do the ceremony, right? You know that, right?
I would love to be it. Listen, I would love to be at the ceremony. I'd love to be at the pregnancy. Like, just let me know. I want to be at the base of the baby coming out.
Definitely.
I'm one of those weird psychics. I was there for my grandchild. I was in the room with my grandchild when he popped out. What? No, nobody can kick me out. No, I stayed. But we all stayed. Everybody was there. All the grandparents. It was a nightmare. I gotta be there. I just told them I would breastfeed my own grandchild if I could. I don't care. I don't care. And you got an amazing reading. So again, I want you to nurture your life right here. I want you to get married. I want you to allow another child to come through. I want that child to be Alyssa to come back through you. So we got some work to do. Let's get started.
Yes, we do. Thank you so much. Let me let you go before your phone starts ringing.
Bye, honey.
Bye. Thank you.
You're welcome, honey. Bye. Bye. G.S. Buckley, me and Jason are going to be at your wedding, but Jason's going to twerk. You're hilarious. We might come to your wedding if it's in another country. I have a funny feeling. God bless you, sister. Oh, yes. You guys are amazing. Okay, let's do it. 300 to 399. Let's go for it. 818-985-2010. Jamaica. I'll come to Jamaica. 300 to 399. Let me put my glasses on because I always do something wrong. Wow, you guys aren't getting it this time. Huh. Not 108, 300 to 399. You guys are not getting it this time. This is going to be severe. For free reading. Free reading. 300 to 399. I am shocked. Use your psychic abilities, guys. Use it. Concentrate. I am shocked. You calm down, everyone. Use your psychic ability. 300 to 399. Okay, Apollonia, you win. Apollonia, 818-985-2010. 818-985-2010. Apollonia, I'm pronouncing it wrong. She's the winner. That took forever. 818-985-2010. 818-985-2010. I really should put a sign up. 818-985-2010. Call me. Could see. What's the number? Oh, I told you. 329 is... damn it. 329 is the number. And Apollonia picked it. Apollonia, where are you? Apollonia, tell me. Come. Where are you? Are you calling? What's happening? December, congrats. No, 329. Apollonia, where are you? Yes, you got it. You did 329. She's running to the phone. Can I have her reading if she doesn't call? Jazz! 818-985. Apollonia? Oh, I'm the worst. 818-985-2010. Apollonia. I always say Apollonia. Ugh, I'm the worst with this stuff. With names, Instagram names. It's the worst for me. Harry Apple. Prince. Oh, I need water. Oh, damn it. Oh, yeah. Water. 818-985-2010. It's behind you. 818-985-2010. Where are you? By the way, if you're international, that could be a problem. By the way, I'm always assuming everyone is where I am. But if you're international, that's a problem. We can always Skype, too. When birds go by, Joe. Yay! Hello.
Hey, there's a free reading person.
Yes. Thank you, Hovik.
Hello.
you? I'm fine, thank you. I'm so fine. It's such a pleasure.
Yes.
So. I could tell you were clueless. I was like, wow, you're one. Listen to me. How do you say your Periscope name?
Apple Nina.
That was part of the problem. I was saying something else.
Yeah, and I thought about one day, see that compliment? Then I look back and everybody else is saying, but no, I'm like, hold
on. I think it's me. How are you? Thank you for being so loyal, by the way. It's such a pleasure. It's such a pleasure. So give me a question.
I lost my mom. I got about 6 years ago, and I don't think I've ever really completely had accepted that she's gone. I let go to an extent, but I still did some things, and I just want to know if she's okay.
Okay. First of all, you know, I would say to you, every time you think of your mom, light a white candle. Okay? And let that be representative in your home that this is my mom.
Okay.
Get a Febreze candle, get a Yankee candle, make sure it's clear, white, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
And every time you light it, like, I'm not a fan of leaving my house and leaving candles on. So every night when you get home, you could do it by your bed. You could do it, you know, in a place in the living room. Every time you light it, say something to your mother. Say something. Let her know. Let her know that you're okay sometimes. You understand? Let her know that you're thinking about her. Okay? I'm getting that there's not enough grieving. Or it was stunted, or you weren't allowed to grieve enough.
Mm-hmm.
And there's no measure with grieving. None. You know, when it gets released from you, it just gets released from you. I don't know if it happens in a month or if it happens in 10 years. But it's yours. You own that. You own that grief. So, because you own it, and it's been 6 years now, make it into a ritual. Because when you work at anything, including grief, that actually is the best way for it to go.
Okay.
All right? I'm a big fan of lighting candles, and in your case, I would add patchouli oil or patchouli herb, a little bit of sprinkled patchouli herb. And all of that helps to release the energy, you know, and pull you away from having one foot in the grave with your mother and one foot here. All right. I think it's amazing that this Periscope is about death and life. All right, but I want you to understand, because I know mamas, all right? There's not a mama that has taken care of her children that wants you grieving this hard for her.
Okay.
All right, because life matters. What you're doing and what you're doing, staying behind and creating her legacy, like, you matter. All right? No one wants a Whitney and Bobby Christina situation. No mom wants that. They don't want you over there. Life matters. So bring on a ritual that honors her without giving up your life.
Okay.
Hold on. What's your mommy's name?
Alex.
What is it?
Alex.
A-L-I-C-E. Say it again.
A-L-I-C-E.
Alice. God, please let Alice come through. please allow Alice to come through. There were no accidents. It took forever for that number to come through, 329. Please let Alice come through. One more. You know what? I'm liking you. Okay, hold on a second. Are you in a relationship?
A marriage.
You're in a marriage. Okay. Okay. She's actually watching over your marriage and your finances. Mm. All right. She says that... She says that... She says that you're too much inside your head.
You're too much inside my head.
Mm-hmm. You've lost your passion. Mm. It's not a willful living, it's just your passion. You've lost your passion. Okay. You're way too much inside your head. She says she's been trying to talk to you though. She's trying to breathe the fire back inside of you. I honestly feel that she's trying to breathe the fire back into your marriage.
Okay.
I need you to get passionate again. I need you to believe. Like, what's your sign?
Virgo.
What's your husband's sign?
He's a Capricorn.
All right, well, something's missing passionately with you guys.
Definitely. Definitely.
Well, you're the one that's getting the reading, not your husband. All right, you're getting the reading. This is coming from your mama, not me this time. All right? Y'all need to get back into a space of, I love this man no matter what. Too much focus on money. Or not enough money. I don't know what's going on with money. But you've lost your fire. This is you. I'm worried that you're not even having enough sex. I want you to open your legs. I want you to mount him. I want the fire back. You don't have to do it today. You know what I mean? Like, I wouldn't do it today because you still have so much grief inside of you. So I want you to get into this ritual of releasing the grief that you have with your mother, which is how the candles are going to help. You know, the candle burns out, you light another one. The candle burns out again, you light another one. You know, every single time you relight the same candle, you have a conversation with your mother. You tell her what is happening in your life right now. I love my husband and I don't know how to do this. You will get some spiritual answers, but you've got to speak it out loud because you've lost your passion. You're holding it all in. He can't figure out the problem. He's just going, okay, you know, this is what it is today. Bring this man back into your life.
Okay.
I also want to be able to say, and this is coming from her, it's not over. Stop worrying about finances. You're always going to have money problems. That's who the both of you are. You know? But I'd rather you have, you know, what you all think is money problems, which I don't really believe you have money problems, but what you all think is money problems, but you're loving each other through it. Like, do that. Like, there's a way to do that. And then, once you all figure that out, money won't be such a high priority. Because you've got each other.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
But you change and he rises. He becomes that man for you again. You change. He's going to be your everything. She's married. What? And as far as sex is concerned, are you crying?
Maybe.
Do you have children? Some Periscope people are like, cry, let it out. I do that because when people come in and they're like, you know, they're crying, I let them cry. I was like, well, stop. Cry. That's therapy. Crying's therapy. It lets you, in a weird kind of way, it does let you heal again. It lets you begin again. It lets you figure out what you really want out of life. And I hear the anger part,
mm-hmm.
without saying too much, I hear the anger part, but I still want you to reinvest in your man.
Okay.
Get him back.
Okay.
He's your husband. Get him back. So, the second half was me, the first half was your mommy. I just kind of went off of what she had come through with.
Okay.
All right, Apollonia.
Thank you so much.
You're so welcome. Many blessings. Do I have you on Instagram?
Yes.
Just yes. DM me your progress.
Okay, I will.
All right. Oh, my God. I want to say I love you, but I don't think it's me. I think it's your mom, because I keep wanting to say, I love you.
Okay.
So take it.
Accept it.
Accept it. Accept it. I'm just the tool. I'm the portal. Accept it. Bye, baby.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Wow. This reading was about death. Oh, no. You never know what's going to come across. Thank you, everyone, for being so supportive. And all the comments to help Melissa's boyfriend to be a healthy, viable human being. Thank you, guys. Melissa's going to look back in the Periscope. And my eyes, oh, I know. They both made me cry. It's weird. I'm not an emotional person. I'm not. I will not be emotional. I will not cry. It's rare if I cry. So rare. I don't cry for nothing. But you two made me tear up today. But I didn't cry. I held it in. Cry with this woman. Okay. I'll cry. I'm a girl. Girls cry. All about the healing. G.S. Buckley, yes, I'm going to hook you and Melissa up. And thank you, everyone, for all your comments. I can't wait to look back on it. I usually don't post the Periscopes on YouTube, but I'm going to post this one. I really believe in all the comments and all the support. It takes a damn village. Hillary Clinton. By the way, Hillary, we need you. Where are you? It takes a village. This is the village. Bye, guys. Thank you. Thank you for tuning in. I'm honored. I'm honored. Mama's watching you, Eponina. Bye, Tracy. Love you. Love you. Thank you, Jennifer. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you, G.S. Buckley. Bring back that flame, girl. Have a great day, Lady Panther. You too. Thank you. Be blessed, Tracy. Thank you, Jagan. You be blessed too. Emojis. Bye, guys.